Okay, it's June 1st, 2010. It's 3:08 p.m. right now. It's a Thursday, and wanted to do a fairly quick video, but I'm not gonna go into a lot of details because the batteries on this camera always goes out when I do long videos. First row was peppers, and we had some storms out here, and those things held on. They're pretty sturdy. The tomatoes we have, we put out, they were all small. And I thought I had one more small one. Yeah, well, that would be the smallest one right down there. Okay, but all these are like the same size ones you see in the China Mart or Kmart someplace. The stems on them are about as thick as my little finger even. That's how sturdy they have become. So I'm gonna get out of the garden real quick. This is number one. Okay, seven tomatoes in there. Six peppers right now. And two basil. Okay, and I got some more tomato steaks I got in here for tomato plants we're growing in the house. 26 garlic in here. I'm not gonna go through all this. I got sunflowers growing outside the garden. Help attract bees and some butterflies and such here and here. Plus the torch sunflower right there, that's the big orange flowers. Hummingbirds love that stuff too. We got three zucchini, one there, and one there. Black zucchini, sunflower seed that dropped, and we're letting it grow right next to it. We've got three cucumber here. There's another one coming up with a seed right down there. I don't know if you can see them, two leaves. I don't know if I can see it on here even. There's two leaves right down there, it's coming up. There should be three that I planted that didn't come up, and I planted two more, that's one of the two. So there's five in here to come up. One more to come up, and there'll be five. More sunflowers, torch sunflowers on the corner. Four broccoli here. We just had our first dose of the worms 2 days ago. Little green line, you will not even know it unless you looked at it really good on these. So we got them all off, about 20 some odd worms around these things. And we got domaceous earth around them. And mulch up around the thing. And see, this is late in the year for these things. That's the bad thing. These are supposed to be out in like February, March, April. We put them out at the end of April. And in May, they were so-so, they were getting stronger. And then now it's getting into June, they're getting hot. It's getting hot out here. Okay, watermelon, one seed was planted down there. Two cantaloupes was planted about 4 days ago, 5 days ago. There's one growing down there, one growing right down there. And then up there, there's two watermelon right there. It's like Woodham watermelon, which is like the long ones. Sugar Baby, which is the small round ones. And then that one there would be Woodham. And the other one over there would be the Sugar Baby. So like opposite corners. Had pumpkin in there, and I planted a bean. I mean, like I said, there's a lot of things I just start planting. So right here, I believe, is maybe two okra going in that hole right there. There are more spots out here where the sticks are generally. Yeah, here's another one. It's coming up. See, it's the heat. With the heat now, the okra is starting to come up. There's an okra right there. I'm afraid I might have covered some with plastic when I planted them about 2 months ago, which is way early. See, I need to start cutting them, folding them at the very least. Okay, here's my watermelons. Here's the one cantaloupe that's growing back here. Here's one of those giant beans right here. Black-eyed peas, two of them. There's like two beans in each hole. This is the Tobias bean. There's two in there. There's two in that hole, and there's two in that hole. And I use chicken wire for these sensing. This is all make as you go. This was all these fences were cut in half, and they were 50-foot in length rows. You know, that one was a 3-foot row. This one was 2-foot row, the chicken wire. So doing the best I can with what I got. Then we got white beans, northern beans. Two beans were down there. Two or three were down there. Two or three. See, there's some bean pods down the bottom down there, too. As you can see, right near the bottom. Okay, so about another week or so, we'll be picking those pods. About the second week of June, third week. These are Mayflower, or no, Jackson Warner bean, butterscotch and Mayflower right here. I don't know which is which, but we got two of each. This one right there is not doing too good. That one's not doing so great. This is Good Mother Stollard. It's a reddish colored bean. That's a pretty good size one there. Good mother. That's a good mother starter right there. This one here was a Trail of Tears Cherokee. Okay, and that over there, I think, I'm not sure on the bean on that one though, but that's another bean. It was, I think it's that giant bean, but I'm not positive. Okay, and there's Lucy, and there's CJ over there next door. Got my sunflowers that aren't coming up as good as I want them to. Like especially all along the northern wall over there. There's some bunch of them that are about 2 inches tall, and that's about it. But look at these. They were all planted at the same time. So it's just sporadic how they're coming up here. On the far end over there, they're coming up too. Should have looked at them while I was over that way, but you know, you can see them on the ground there. You see those little patches of sunflowers. So this is the 2017 garden. It's coming out really, really good. The beans and all that, we're planting more and more beans, so we'll have a lot of beans and some peas. Good tomatoes out here, peppers. I got some peppers in the side garden, which we have lettuce in the house, but again, lettuce and broccoli grow better when it's like February. You plant them at the end of February while it's cold, and then by the end of April, or going into May, you should have your lettuce and your broccoli. We didn't do that. We did it really late, so I'm hoping those broccoli will come out, that they'll come out. Same thing with the lettuce we got planted in the house. There's a bunch of them, but they're all small in those little, what do you call them, those little cells, those little plastic cells. I got five jalapeno pepper plants right here. Everything in that garden that we ever have is from a seed. We don't buy plants and put them out. We did it once before, which was a mistake, and won't do it again. But everything we do is from seed. And it's just timing. We're doing bad on timing. I made this one a little bit smaller because, you know, they're going to put more peppers out here. Might put, we got like about 10 tomatoes in there. We got room. We might put them in the number two garden where there's no plastic. Put about four over there. And still put some by the side house there too. In the house, the one by the house I just looked at. Might put about four tomatoes in there. A couple peppers. And then put a couple over there too. So I'll fill it all out. But that's the garden, okay? It's pretty decent. I mean, everything is coming up just about. A couple, there's one, there's at least three cucumbers that didn't come up at all. There's one more of the two I just planted about a week ago. One of them is starting to come up. Pumpkin somewhere, there should have been a pumpkin back there. And I showed you the okra that's coming up. There's probably more down there. I gotta check all them plastic X's and fold the plastic corners under so it's not suffocating them. Zucchini is doing pretty decent. I'd like to have one more zucchini. I might still plant another zucchini right over there somewhere. Or in the back corner. Close to the corner there. It's the grass is what's a pain. And like I said, the tomatoes and the peppers over there are doing good. The tomatoes are doing extremely good. So, there you go. 8 minutes.